Good morning, children. In the last class, I taught you lesson number 2 of your class 9 PHI book, The Sound of Music. And in that class, I taught you the part 1. And the part 1 is about Evelyn Glennie, who listens to sound without hearing it. I told you about Evelyn Glennie, that she is a deaf girl who, through her determination, hard work and devotion to music, achieved her goal in life. Evelyn Glennie's story is an inspiration for the young generation. And I told you that when she was very young, at that time she lost her hearing power due to nerve damage. And when her parents came to know about it, they were very much disappointed, and even it was the end of life for Evelyn Glennie. But through her determination, through her strong willpower, she decided that she is not going to lead the life of a physically disabled child. She decided that she will lead a normal life. And then we came to know in the story that her teachers, her classmates, they did not support her, they did not encourage her. But one of the percussionists, Ron Forbes, he recognized her talent and he supported her to achieve her goal. And then we came to know in the story that through her hard work and determination, she achieved her goal and she became one of the multi-percussionists, and she inspires the physically disabled child. She tells them that if she can do, if she can achieve her goal, why can't they? So in this session, I will be discussing with you the question answers of part 1. So I will be discussing with you the questions, the types of questions which you get in exam. So first you get the comprehension passage, and in this you get the 4 questions of 1 mark each. So the first comprehension passage is, by the time she was 11, her marks had deteriorated and her headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist. So these lines are taken from the part 1, lesson 2, Evelyn Glennie. And the first question is, who is she referred to here? So she is here referred to Evelyn Glennie. And why did her marks deteriorate? Her marks deteriorated because of her hearing disability. So when she, till 11 years she was able to hear, but after that her hearing power started deteriorating and it affected her performance also. So that is why her marks started deteriorating. And why did the headmistress urge her parents for? So the answer is, the headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist. She was unable to study in the class with the normal children. So the headmistress advised her parents to take her to a specialist and to admit her in a special school for the deaf children. Then next question is, find a word from the passage that means the same as strong advice. So the correct word is urged. So you get these questions for 1 mark each. So you have to write your answer in 1 sentence only. If the question is for 1 mark, you will write 1 sentence. And if it is for 2 marks, you will write 2 sentences only. Now, the next comprehension passage we will do. Most of the teachers discouraged her, but percussionist Ron Forbes spotted her potential. He began by tuning 2 large drums to different notes. So you read in the story that the percussionist Ron Forbes, he encouraged her, he recognized her talent and taught her music. The first question here is, why did most of the teachers discourage her? So most of the teachers discouraged her because of her deafness, because of her physical disability. Why did Ron Fobbs decide to teach her? Ron Fobbs decided to teach her because he recognized her potential and supported her in achieving her goal. So Ron Fobbs recognized that Evelyn Glennie had a talent to learn music. So that is why he supported her in achieving her goal. And how did he try to teach her? He advised her not to listen through her ears, but try to sense it and feel it some other way. So he advised Evelyn not to listen through her ears. She could not listen because she was deaf. So he told her, he advised her to feel the music, to feel the vibrations of different instruments and then feel them through her body parts. Now the next question is, find a word from the passage that means the same as ability. So the word here is potential. So now I will discuss with you the short answer type questions, and you have to answer these questions in 30-40 words. So I am giving you the main point, so you will develop these answers in your own language. So if these questions you get for 2 marks, and for 2 marks you have to write 2 value points. Only then you will get the full marks. So at what age was Evelyn's initial hearing weakness discovered? So when she was 8 years old, her hearing disability was confirmed, and by the time she was 11, she was completely blind because of the nerve damage. So you will write the answer in your own language with the help of these value points. Now the next question is, why did Ron Fobbs encourage her? So why did Ron Fobbs encourage her? Because he recognized her potential and supported her in achieving her goal. He gave her practice to recognize the different sounds through her body parts. Now the next question is, how does she feel sound while playing on the xylophone? So when she plays on the xylophone, she feels that the sound, the vibrations from her fingers, from the stick, are moving to her fingers, and she could feel the vibrations in every part of her body. And why does she remove her shoes while playing on a wooden platform? Because she wants to feel the vibrations through her bare feet. Now, next question is, which important award was presented to Evelyn in 1991? In 1991, she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year Award. So, you will write, you will elaborate these answers with the help of these value points given. Now, next type of question you get in exam is the long answer type question or value based question. And this is a long question, and you get the long question for 8 marks. So accordingly you have to write. So I have given here the value points of the question, of the answer, and you will, with the help of these points, you will develop your answer and write the answer for 8 marks. So what are the values of Evelyn's character? First of all, we came to know in the story that she was very hardworking and she had strong determination. So when she came to know that she has become deaf, at that time she decided that she is not going to lead a life of a deaf child. She will lead the life of a normal child. Then we came to know her devotion towards music. She was very much devoted towards music. And then optimistic. She was optimistic also. In spite of her disability, she was never depressed, she was never disappointed, and she was optimistic about her life that one day she will achieve her goal. And then we came to know that she was courageous also. She did not lose hope. She was not depressed when she came to know of her disability. And in the last, we came to know that she does social work also. She performs in hospitals and prison. Free of cost. She is a multi-percussionist and she is workaholic. She likes to work continuously. She likes to work for the welfare of the disabled children. And that is why she is a source of inspiration for deaf children. She tells them if she can achieve her goal in spite of her deafness, why can't other people? So, with the help of these points, you will develop the answer. I hope you have understood the lesson. You have understood all types of questions. You will note down all these question answers in your FAIR register. And I'll teach you next chapter in the next class. Till then, goodbye and take care.